So in the last video, we set up Supervisor and we saw that we had to turn daemonization off for both Nginx and Supervisor. Now what we did not take care of just yet is PHP. And PHP is going to need the same treatment. And I'll show you that here. If I do docker run, and I'm going to do the same command as before, except we're doing IT here, we're not doing the -d flag, we're not pushing this into the background. We're going to keep this running in the foreground of our session here. And it's going to output the log stuff from Supervisor. And one thing you'll notice is that we have some error saying FPM initialization failed. An FPM instance seems to already be running or listening at this socket file it's trying to create. And in fact, if we head over here and head to localhost port 8080 and do index.php, we're going to see that PHP is actually working. So PHP at FPM is actually running, but it's not getting set to run in the foreground. So Supervisor is actually losing track of it because it daemonizes itself. So what we want to do is actually stop it from daemonizing itself. And what we want to do there is to create a configuration file. So I'm going to do docker ps to show this. I'll do docker exec-it. And we're going to run bash inside of that running container. So let's head over to etsy php 7.2 fpm, where we have the configuration for php fpm. And I'm going to cat out php fpm here, the configuration file. And we're going to search for the word daemonize. I'll just say daemon. And we can see that by default, daemonize is set to yes. So what we want to do is change this. So what I want to do is just grab this entire phpfpm.conf file and just make the few changes that we want. And to do that, I'm going to run docker exec again, but instead of bash, I'm just going to cat out the file phpfpm.conf, this file here that we just looked at. And we can do that, right? You don't just have to run bash when you're running execute. You can execute any command against a container. So I'm going to run the cat command, and it's going to be etsy php 7.2 fpm, and then that php-fpm.conf file. This will echo out that entire file here to our standard out, and I'm just going to pipe that right over to pbcopy, which on my Macintosh is going to paste it, put it into my clipboard, so I can hit paste, and I'll get this huge string of that configuration. So here, let's create this file that I just got into my clipboard, php-fpm.conf. Paste in that. Let's search for daemonize, and not this one. I want daemonize here, and we'll just set that to now. Okay, so let's head to our Docker file here, and we can add that. We'll just add another line here. We can use add again. We don't need to keep using copy. So I'm going to add the file phpfpm.conf to its same location inside of the container so that we are able to override the daemonize flag there. Okay, let's rebuild this. So let's see, docker ps, I still have this running. I'll cancel it out over here using control C. And I started it with the remove flag, so there's no more containers running. Get rid of this tab just to clean it up. Run docker build again, the exact same command. We're going to overwrite the image shipping docker app at the tag latest. It's running really quick because once again, we just added one line to the end of the docker file. So it just saves and uses cache for all the other layers, for all the other changes here, until it gets to our new thing, the add phpfpm.conf, and then anything under it, right? Anything under it is also not cached. So the higher the change you make, the worse it is in terms of performance for making a new image. But anyway, we added phpfpm.conf, so I should be able to run another docker run command, the exact same as before, IT, so we see the output and can potentially interact with it if we need to. And this time we see it is successful, right? Where phpfpm entered the running state. So Supervisor doesn't lose track of it and it is still up and running. So refresh, that php file is still up and running. Perfect. Okay, in the next video, let's cover Docker logs and see its logging mechanism, which we're seeing a little bit of here.